You may recall it was just last August the Delmarva Life Sean Stryker took the Ice Bucket Challenge with some friends at Peninsula Regional Medical Center. The challenge was a creative way to call attention to a debilitating disease that kills many within 2 to 5 years after diagnosis.
Yeah, and from the Ice Bucket Challenge, the ALS Association has received $115 million in donations, which is amazing. But if you take into consideration that living with ALS can cost more than $200,000 per year, well, that number doesn't seem so big. According to the ALS Association, there are 30,000 people in the U.S. living with ALS. There are 5,600 people diagnosed with the disease each year, and the average lifespan after diagnosis is 2 to 5 years.
And that's why it's so important that you continue giving support. And one way of doing that is by getting out and participating in a walk to defeat ALS. Lucky for you, there's one being held this weekend in Salisbury. Delmarva Life Sean Stryker joins us now from the home of an ALS patient who's getting ready to partake in her first ALS walk. So, Sean, now normally this walk is held in the fall, right?
It's actually normally held in October, but they decided to move it to April this year, and here to tell us why and what we can expect from this year's walk are my new friends, Sharon and Karen. Sharon, you're the coordinator at PRMC, and Karen, you're getting ready to participate in your first walk.
Absolutely.
Sharon, let's start over here with you. Why did they move the walk this year?
Because last year they had all 8 walks in the fall for the entire, also the ALS Association, and they decided if they split it in half and did 4 in the spring and 4 in the fall, then the walk coordinator could spend more time helping each individual place do their walk.
So the time is pretty much the only thing that changed. It's still a lot of fun. Tell me, what can people expect?
Well, I hope we expect over 200 people. We have a disc jockey. We have Captain Willie. Yay! We have a kids' bouncy house. Last year we had face painters. We have an advocacy tent. We have shirts. We have all kinds of things going on all day. Food, drinks, water only. Sorry, folks. And it's just a really fun day, and hopefully the weather's going to be beautiful this year.
Well, we were looking at the weather, and it's supposed to be. And it's all to raise money for ALS, and this year you're shooting for $50,000. How are you guys doing?
We're about halfway there right now, but we have until October to complete that $50,000 goal. I would really like to get there because that money is so important to our patients. It furnishes them with equipment, it gives them grants for transportation, it helps them with caregiving, and of course, best, it gives us Sherry Singer, who is our ALS patient care coordinator.
Now, Karen, you just started going to the ALS clinic here in Salisbury.
About a year ago.
And you were diagnosed about a year ago.
Right.
What has the past year been like for you?
Well, at first it was really difficult, but with the support of the clinic and the support group especially, it's been a pretty good year, you know? I mean, I have ALS, obviously, and it's working its progression, but having this support is a wonderful thing. I mean, it keeps your spirits up, and you can talk to somebody, and it's just a good experience.
So why are you looking forward to the walk this year?
Well, my grandkids are coming in from Maine, and my daughter, and I've raised $4,500,
wow,
I think,
and
I'm pushing for a little more than that. So, yeah, I'm excited about it. So.
Well, ladies, thanks so much. Real quick before we go, when is the walk happening? Give me the date and time.
It's this Saturday, April the 18th. Registration's at noon, and the walk actually kicks off at 1 o'clock.
Well, that sounds like a lot of fun. So get out and walk to defeat ALS. For more information on that walk, all you have to do is visit our website, WBOC.com. Just click on our picture at the top of the page. Jimmy and Lisa, back to you guys.
How about that?
How about that?
So just get up and go. That's the way to do it. It is for such a great cause. Now, you may recognize these guys who get up and go, all in the name of ALS research, Chris and Peyton Lambton of the HGTV show Going Yard. Since Chris's mom was diagnosed with ALS and eventually lost her battle, Chris and Peyton run something called the Falmouth Road Race with Compassionate Care ALS. Chris and his brothers have also participated in the ALS Ice Bucket Challenge. He says the organization Compassionate Care ALS does a lot for patients living with the disease.
My mother, she had ALS, she passed away, so it's an organization that's near and dear to my heart. They really helped our family out, and they help out tons of patients with ALS. So every year we run the Falmouth Road Race, We raise money for people with ALS. They help give you everything you need. If you have ALS, it's you know, obviously it's a terrible disease, so we do what we can for people who are battling with it.
Now, you may also remember Kristen Lambden and Peyton Wright Lambden for their roles as contestants on The Bachelor and The Bachelorette.
Well, something else many are battling, attempting the sale of a home alone. There's probably much more involved than you ever thought. Up next, we learn the importance of having a realtor, how paying a little extra money now may pay off in the long run.
And once you do sell your home, do you know who's going to move all of your things? Coming up, Angie Hicks of Angie's List tells us what we need to think about before deciding and if the hassle is worth it. Now, Marvel Life, we'll be right back.